This is my cotton embroidery thread, and I need these scissors. And this is a little cardstock card or tablet to wrap the embroidery thread around. And I have a template that I will send to you by email, and you could use that. You might want to make these edges just a little bit bigger, because I'm finding this is a little bit challenging to hold on to. But after I traced and cut this shape, I cut two slits on one end at an angle. I'm gonna move these things closer to me and move my tray to the side, and I'll need these glasses. So I'm going to take one end of the embroidery thread and just hold that about in the middle of the tablet and hold that with my thumb. Oops. And then this is going to slide right through that slit. And then I'm going to just bring this around and wrap it. In a way, it's similar to when I made the string crosses. And you've made some too, because it's wrapping. It also reminded me, I need to pull a little bit more thread out. It also reminded me of when we make the metal insets and we draw the curvy lines. And at first, they're not so close together, but as you practice doing your metal insets and you're getting them closer and closer together, then it almost looks like it's just one solid color. And this reminded me of that. So I'm going to keep on wrapping until I get to the other end of this tablet. Pull out some more thread. And when I complete going around on I'm going from the right to the left. I tried to go from the left to the right, but this seemed like it felt better to me. You can decide. And when I get to this end, I'm going to come back. I'm just going to start going from left to right now. Now it's not so hard. And again, I want to put my thread, wrapping it around as close together as I can, so that the thread actually touches the thread that was wrapped just before it. And to make this more secure, you could probably glue the thread at the beginning, or use some double stick tape, because when we get to the end, I'm going to tuck the last little tail underneath the thread, just like I did with that first tail. And this comes around one more time, and I'm going to pull it through that little slot and just leave a little tiny tail. And then I'm just going to push that underneath the thread. Just like that. And there I have a color tablet that I made all by myself. And you know what? I like it. I think it's beautiful. I'm going to put this away and show you something else. I forgot to push my chair in the last time. I'm glad I remembered. So I found this beautiful box to put matching color tablets in, just like Color Box 2. I love the beautiful box, and I love what the color tablets look like inside. They're so pretty. So this would be just like the color tablet work that we do in the classroom. And I'm carefully holding on to just this edge because Dr. Montessori told the children not to touch the beautiful silk embroidery thread because we have oils in our fingers and we do not want that to get onto the thread because it could damage it and change the color. So I'm being very careful. And it's really, really challenging for me because it's so beautiful. I sort of would love to touch it, but I'm not gonna, not anymore, because I want to keep the thread as beautiful as I can. Some of these are a little bit challenging for me to get out, but I did it. Box, set that to the side. We'll start with red. I'm looking for another red one. Do you see it? There it is. I'll choose blue. Do you see the blue one? Do you see the yellow one? Now I want green. Do you see the green one? And orange. It's getting a little easier. Do you see the orange one? And purple. And that is very easy because it's the only one left. Now, you could find something in your in your house that has the same color. And look, I have something right here. They look like different shades, but they're both purple. Well, that reminds me of another activity that I must show you. So I'm going to put these color tablets away. And again, when you put them away, only touch those edges, remembering that our fingers have oils in them and that could damage the thread. You know what? I'm going to mix these up because if I do this another time, I want a little bit of a challenge, I think. And you would like a challenge too. I'm going to carefully pick them up by those edges. And one, and let's start again. I love this beautiful box. It's made of different kinds of wood. They even have different shades of brown. Well, the next thing I'm going to show you are some color tablets that we can grade the colors from the darkest to the lightest. I tried to find very pretty boxes because all of the materials should call to the children, come work with me. And then when I open the box, let me see, this way. Now, in our classroom, when we do the grading of the color tablets, there are 7 shades of each color, and there are usually 9 sets in a box. I only have 5, but it will give you the idea of grading colors from the darkest to the lightest. And I only have 3 different colors. So I'll show you what the box looks like. And I'm just going to choose 1 color. Let's see, I think I'd choose blue. And again, I'm only holding the white edges because I want to be very careful not to touch the embroidery thread. Close the box and set that to the side. Now I need to decide which one is the darkest. I wonder if you can tell which one is the darkest. Do you know what I do sometimes? This is really helpful for me. I choose one that I think is the darkest shade, and then I compare it. This is darker. 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 Darkest. I'm going to put that one right up here at the top. I think this one is the darkest, but I'm going to check to be sure. Darker. Darker. These two look similar. I'll try this one. What do you think? I think this one's lighter. This one is darker. And this is the lightest shade of blue. Darkest, lighter. Lighter, lighter, lightest. And then you could even take a shade of the color blue and look around your home and see if you can find something that matches it. Or you could leave the color here and go search for it and see if you can hold that color in your memory. That is so hard for me. But what I'm wondering is, I'm all dressed in blue. Let me see. Do any of these shades match me? I wonder. Check. Maybe the lightest shade of blue. Oh my gosh, that is such a good match. Maybe this one, I'll try it. Do you think it matches? Oh, I think I see it. Do you see the match? Right there, I have shades of blue right on my skirt. I wonder if this one matches. Let's check. It's close. It looks like this one. I'm not sure. What about this one? Let's check. Yeah, maybe it's pretty close to this one. I don't know if this darkest blue will match. Let's check. Nope, this one is lighter and this is darker. So you can check around at your house and after you make these and see if you can find things that match. That was so much fun for me. It was fun to make the color tablets and it was fun to do the work. And you could do this as many times as you like. Keep it in a special container and put it in a special place in your house so that you will know where to find it. And you could do it as many times as you like. Have a lovely day. And